Hello, dear friends. How are you?
We are continuing with the special article by Rabbi Ashlag. We already did the first article called The Giving of the Bible. The first article from the book of Rabbi Ashlag, Giving of the Bible. The first article was Giving of the Bible. Now we are on the second article called Mutual Guarantee. So here I put it on the screen and you all can watch it and read it together with me. You can also find this article on my website, lovekabbalah.com, and let's read. Today it's the second lesson from this article. Thus, you evidently find that the giving of the Torah had to be delayed until they came out of Egypt and became a nation of their own, meaning when all their needs were provided for by themselves, independently of others. This qualified them to receive the above arvut, and then they were given the Torah. It turns out that even after the reception of the Torah, if a handful from Israel betray and return to the field of self-love without consideration of others, that same amount of need that is put in the hands of those few would burden each one in Israel with the need to provide for it themselves, because those few will not pity them at all. So it says that the Torah could be given to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob many years before, but it was delayed. And only after the nation of Israel came out of Egypt, the nation of Israel, it's not just talking about a nation that lived or live, thousands of years ago or today. It's every one of us who have the inner consciousness called Israel. And when our consciousness, when we still enslaved in Egypt, what does it mean to be enslaved in Egypt? It means that we still kind of thinking in consciousness of slavery, thinking in a consciousness of victim consciousness, means thinking in a consciousness that, I'm waiting for someone to make me happy. I'm waiting for something to happen so I'll be fulfilled. Once you're still thinking and having that consciousness, you cannot accept and receive the Torah. What is the Torah? The Torah is the light from the Creator that gives you the energy to start to be a channel of God, to start to be a channel of love for others and for the world. When you still worry all day long, how this gonna be a fix in my life, how that gonna be fixed, how things gonna ever be, how would I ever be happy? How would I ever be successful? When you still thinking about yourself and your own, let's say, emptiness, and how to fulfill that emptiness, you're still in this consciousness called slavery. When the people of Israel left Egypt, it means that they actually left that old consciousness of what will be with me, and they enter a new consciousness of I'm a free person. Free person means I'm not dependent on anything. I'm only dependent on God. And when I have consciousness of sharing and caring and loving, I have the same frequency of God. I become similar to God. I become like God. I become attached to God. I become partner of God. I become unified with God, and then I'll have everything in my life. Nothing will be missing. I have nothing to worry or to be afraid. And Rabbi Ashlag want to make the point that before the people of Israel left Egypt, they could not receive the Torah because they still had that kind of consciousness of what will be with me. And it's also for us. If we want to receive the light of the Torah, means to receive the strength from God, to become his channels, to share his light with the world, We first of all need to accept that idea that I'm not a slave. I'm not dependent on anything. In order to be happy and successful, it's only dependent on how much I'm a channel of God and how much I'm attaching myself to the Creator that will make me successful and happy, and everything that I need in my life will be fulfilled. Let's continue a little bit more. One second. Hence, the fulfillment of the mitzvah of loving one's friend will be prevented from the whole of Israel. Thus, these rebels cause those who observe the Torah to remain in their field of self-love, for they will not be able to engage in the mitzvah. Love your friend as yourself, and complete their love of others without their help. He wants to say, you know, the same way that the body, it's a one complete organ, even though we have a lot of little organs. So every organ of the body is actually dependent on all the other organs, the ears and the legs and the hands and the liver and the heart and the lungs and all the brain. Everything is affecting each other and everything dependent on each other. So if, for example, one organ say, I don't feel like to walk today. I don't feel like to all day long just care for the body and care and make sure that all the other organs will be fulfilled and happy and okay. So the entire body can collapse if the heart would say that, or the brain would say that, or any other organ would say that. Yeah, right? All of us, all the people of Israel, and actually the truth is all the people of the world, we are one big body, one big organ, little organs that creating one big kind of organ. And we all affecting each other and dependent on each other. If we wake up in the morning with consciousness, I understand that everyone is dependent on me. And it's a privilege to realize that the world is dependent on me. That's why I'll push myself even more to share and to give and to provide positive energy to the world, because the world is dependent on me. And if I'm choosing today to just be into myself and to say, you know what, I don't really feel like to care for the world and to be a channel 24/7 of love to the world, I don't really feel like, you know. So the entire world, it will affect the entire world. It can hurt the entire world. It can block the entire world. How much responsibility we have. Let's read a little bit more. You therefore see that all of Israel are responsible for one another, both on the positive side and on the negative side. On the positive side, if they keep the avut to the point that each one cares and satisfies the need of his friends, they can fully observe the Torah and mitzvot commandments, meaning to bring contentment to their maker, as mentioned in Matan Torah, item 13. On the negative side, if a part of the nation does not want to keep the avut, but to allow in self-love, they cause the rest of the nation to remain immersed in their filth and lowliness without finding a way out of their filth. So from here we learned how much, as we just said, how much responsibility we have for each other and for the entire world. And if we realize that if we all care for each other and share with each other, caring for each other doesn't mean that necessarily I need physically to go and feed every person in the world and take care of the physical needs of every person, because we cannot do it. It's, you know, it's beyond our physical ability. But how much love can we share? We can share endless love. How much time we can share? It's limited. We are limited in time. How much money, how much physicality we can share? It's limited. But how much love can you share? It's unlimited. There's endless love in the universe. There's endless love that God constantly gives you. So you can share endless love every second of your life. If you're doing your prayers, feuding Yohanan BeKoach or Zohar. Just share love. When you see the other person, smile. Don't be stingy in loving the other person. It doesn't cost you anything. Smile. Think positive. Pray for the other person. Wish good for the other person. We have endless love to share. And doesn't cost anything just to share. Just to share endless love all the time. So we in charge and we're responsible for each other all the time. We're responsible for the entire world. But if we say, I don't want to play this game of filling the world with love. So the world is waiting for you. The world needs your love. The world needs your light. The world is dependent on you, not just the world. As we said, the souls, when they were created by God, they could and they did receive all the endless love of God. And what we said to God, God, we want to share as well. We want to give as well. We want to give you the same way that you give us. We want to give you endless love. So God created for us a world that when we're sharing with each other, when we're caring for each other, it brings him joy. It brings him contentment. So it's in our interest to share with each other. It's in our interest to love each other, because when we're loving and caring for each other, it brings joy to the Creator. And that's our most deep desire of our soul. Let's just today just read one more, number 18. Therefore, the Tana, means Rabbi Shimon Mochai, described the Avot as two people who were on a boat, and one of them began to drill a hole in the boat. His friend says, why are you drilling? He replied, why should you mind? I'm drilling under me, not under you. So he replied, fool, we will both drown together in the boat. Meaning, as we said, since those rebels wallow in self-love by their actions, they build an iron wall that prevents the observers of the Torah from even beginning to fully observe the Torah and mitzvot in the measure of words, love your friend as yourself, which is the ladder for achieving dvekut, adhesion or cleaving with him. Indeed, we write, how right were the words of the proverb that said, fool, we will both drown together in the boat. So it's a story from the Zohar, as we just read, two people sitting in the boat, and one start to drill a hole, and the other person say, what are you doing? The other one said, it's my side of the boat, I paid for it. Don't tell me what to do in my side of the boat. He said, yes, but don't you realize? We're both in the same boat. We're both going to drown. Sometimes in our life, especially in the modern times, people say, don't tell me what to do with my personal life. It's my life, and I'll choose and decide what to do with my life. It's not exactly working like that. Because when you into yourself and you're not sharing your light with the world missing some of its light because you didn't channel. It's not your light. You should remember it's the light of God. You are just a channel. And if you're not channeling the light of God, every person is a channel for specific light. And if we choose or we don't put enough effort to be channeled, to channel the light of God, some of the light of God is not shining in the world and it's affecting all of us. So we have to wake up and realize I'm not just an individual person. We all affecting each other. We all dependent on each other. And we all have responsibility for each other. So let's kind of wake up and realize that all of us should push ourselves every day, realizing that every moment that I'm sharing love and light with others and with the world, the entire world is benefiting. It's bringing joy to the Creator. When I'm too much into myself, into my own taking, and God forbid could block energy that was supposed to be revealed in the world, And it's also blocking the world, blocking me. And also, God forbid, it's where all the joy and all the love that we wanted to give to the Creator. So that was number 18. Zat Hashem, next time we'll do number 19. Thank you. I'm so happy that you following these lessons. Please continue these lessons. This information is super important for us and for the world. And you're welcome to invite friends to join these important lessons. Thank you. Take care and much blessings.